Last November, we saw NASA's deep space program lift off with the Artemis 1 test mission. It's designed to pave the way for sending humans into deep space.
Our Space Coast Bureau Chief Scott Heidler was listening in as Artemis leadership talked lessons learned. So, Scott, what were the main takeaways here?
Well, the program leadership, like they did back in December when Orion splashed down after that test mission, declaring it a success. Now, 3 months on, they've identified a few areas that they need to focus on before the next mission with astronauts on board.
Splashdown.
The Orion spacecraft splashing down in the Pacific Ocean on December 11th, bringing the first Artemis mission to a close.
We did have a record-breaking mission in terms of where Orion went to the moon. You know, we got as close as 80 miles to the surface of the moon, and we traveled further than any human spacecraft has gone before, 270,000 miles from Earth.
And here we go.
Tuesday, NASA program leaders briefing on what they learned from the test mission as they gear up for the return of humans to the moon. The heat shield on the Orion spacecraft is one of the key safety features once astronauts are on board. While charring was expected, there were little pieces of heat shield that eroded off when Orion re-entered Earth's atmosphere at 5,000 degrees.
Some of it we're seeing as larger, like more of a little pieces that are coming off versus being ablated. And I think that's one of the things that was a little bit unexpected. As we return back from the moon.
And the mobile launcher that held the 320-foot-tall SLS rocket stacked into position on Launch Pad 39B sustained a bit more damage than expected, mainly to blast doors, elevators, and hosing lines, but the head of the ground system says those repairs are already underway. The other, more delicate systems carried on without major issues. As for the future, an Artemis II mission manager saying that is set to blast off November 2024. It'll take four astronauts out to orbit the moon and then back, but that's paving the way for the next mission 12 months later that'll put humans back on the moon. Reporting live in the Space Coast, Scott Heidler, West 2 News.